I'm Ken Delo, and this is the backstage green room here in Branson, where our important guests like you are invited to wait for us after the show. We had a room just like this at the ABC studios for all those years. So I guess there are some things in showbiz that never change. One of the things that always changed on the Welk show was the theme. We had a new one every week, and it gave us the framework to do all kinds of songs that maybe we'd never put together otherwise. And the theme of the show you're about to see is By the Numbers. And you'll see the truly creative way that our director, Jim Hobson, and associate producer, Jack Immel, took the word number and used it every way possible. But wait a second, the hands of the clock are racing, so we better get to show number 370, broadcast originally in the first week of the 10th month of 1978, so we can enjoy those 18 great musical numbers. You see how we snuck all those numbers in together?
This evening is called By the Numbers. Many of your all-time favorites, like this one, Four-Leaf Clover. One, two, three, four. It's a very popular number, especially for a romantic twosome like Norma Zimmer and Jimmy Roberts.
We have lots of fun putting together our own dance routines for the show. We work on each one 3 hours a day for 2 weeks.
Well, first we find out the theme of the show, and then we choose music to fit the theme. Tonight's theme is By the Numbers.
A tune called One, from the hit Broadway musical about dancers, A Chorus Line. And we always rehearse in front of a mirror.
First, we think of a step, we add a step, and it makes a combination.
Plie, kick, turn, knee pops.
Now, if you wonder why we don't bump into each other...
or step on each other's toes...
we dance by the numbers. Each step has a count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Like that.
Music. Here's an idea. Cross, leap, 3 and 4. What's next?
How about double flip, arabesque? Let's put them together. 2, 3, and 4.
Now let's try...
Wasn't that great? A behind-the-scenes demonstration of how Bobby and Cissy worked on their numbers every week, topped off by their own interpretation of the choreography from A Chorus Line. I really enjoyed seeing it again. And their description of their work inspires me to tell you a little bit about what I do here in Branson. I'm the MC and singer at the Champagne Theater. I work nonstop for 7 months a year, from April through October, and then Mary Lou Metzger takes over for the Christmas show. On my off time, I keep busy doing shows around the country with other Welk stars, as well as my own one-man show of singing and comedy. And one of the other things I do here is the audience warm-up at every show, and sometimes people send me notes about their birthdays, anniversaries, and other special occasions. And one time I actually got a note someone sent backstage. A couple was celebrating their 45th wedding anniversary. They've been happily married for 3 years. When I came out, I had to ask, I said, which 3 years? And the man answered me. He said, you take it one day at a time and add them all up. Now, I don't know what happened when he got home, because 3 years out of 45 is not too good. Now, there's a man who is about to have heartaches by the number.
Heartache number one was when you left me. I never knew that I could hurt this way. And heartache number two was when you came back. again. You came back and never meant to stay. Now I've got heartaches by the number, troubles by the score. Every day you love me less, each day I love you more. Yes, I've got heartaches by the number, a love that I can't win. But the day that I stop counting, that's the day my world will end. Heartache number three was when you called me and said that you were coming back to stay. Door. I waited, but you must have lost your way. Now I've got heartaches by the number, troubles by the score. Every day you love me less, each day I love you more. Yes, I've got heartaches by the number, love that I can't win. But the day that I stop counting, that's the day my world will end.
Ladies and gentlemen, one of the joys of my life is helping young people develop their talents. The Aldridge sisters and the Otwell twins tell me this next song has been number one in the nation for the last couple of months. Let's hear it by these very popular youngsters, the brothers and the sisters.
I've got chips and multiplied eggs, and I'm losing control, 'cause of power. Electrifying. Better shape up, cause I need a man.
Need a man.
And my heart is set on you. You better shape up. You better understand.
Understand.
To my heart I must be true. Got a little love for me and you. You're the one that I want. You are the one I want. You're the one that I want, you are the one I want, boo, boo, boo. Honey, you're the one that I want, you are the one I want, boo, boo, boo. You're all I need, oh yes indeed. If you feel the right affection, but you're too shy to relay, meditate. Cause I need a man.
Need a man.
Who can keep me satisfied. You better shape up. Oh, you got to prove.
Better prove.
That my fate is justified.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm sure down deep inside. You're the one that I want. You are the one I want. Boo, boo, boo. Honey, you're the one that I want. You are the one I want. Boo, boo, boo. Honey, you're the one that I want. You are the one I want. Boo, 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 you're all I need. Oh, yes, indeed.
The Aldriches and the Otwells, rapidly becoming a number one attraction all around the country. You all know Lawrence's favorite numbers, a one and a two. So this next song seems quite fitting. We'll hear Ken Delo and some of his friends, and a one paddle and a two paddle.
That's it, gang. Nice and easy with the oars. Very rhythmic. That's nice. One paddle, two paddle, three paddle, four to take me home. 14 on the right, 14 on the left. Take me to Hawaii, I know the best. You're kind of... Would you switch places? You're splashing me with the oar, okay? That's all right. Thank you.
For to take me home. 14 on the right, 14 on the left. Take me to Hawaii, a nook of best.
Joe, would you switch? I went away a long time, such a long time ago. Seen enough cities to last a lifetime. Going away no more, no more.
No more.
Oh, would you switch with me?
One paddle, two paddle, three paddle, four, and take me home. 14 on the right, 14 on the left. Take me to Hawaii, I look the best.
Art, would you switch with me? long time ago. And I've seen enough fences to last a lifetime. Going away no more.
One paddle, two paddle, three paddle, four to take me home.
Four to take me home. Excuse me, would you please switch?
Four to take me home. Home. Home.
Okay. You all right?
Getting knocked out of a canoe with a paddle is just one of a number of things they had me do on the Welk show. I had buckets of water thrown at me, got pies in my face, and once I had to spend a lot of extra hours working with a chimpanzee so he'd get to know me when I sang to him on the show. It all went real well. At the end of the song, the chimp gave me a big kiss, and then, as if it was planned, he looked into the camera and wiped the kiss off his lips. And all the time, I thought he really cared for me and was about to whisper those three little words.
George Cates, our musical director, wrote a fine arrangement of three little words. George also consented to let me conduct this number. Gentlemen, one and two and...
Thank you. boss is really happy when the boys are swinging. Tom Netherton picked a beautiful ballad with a timely title for this numbers show, Two Different Worlds.
Two different worlds, we live in two different worlds, for we've been told that a love like ours could never be. So far apart, they say we're so far apart, and that we haven't the right to change our destiny. When will they learn that a heart doesn't draw a line? Nothing matters if I am yours and you are mine. Two different worlds, we live in two different worlds, but we will show them as we walk together in the sun, that our two different worlds are one. Our two different worlds are
much, ladies and gentlemen. This next song has nothing to do with the theme of our show this evening, but we have a very special reason for playing it. The gentleman who recorded it and made it famous is in our audience, and it would be so nice if all of you folks would give Sammy Kaye a great big welcome. Sammy Kaye. What a great pleasure to have you with us. Now let's listen to the song Sammy made so very popular. You'll hear our fine saxophone section and our pretty girls. Visit with us.
We always appreciated and enjoyed having celebrities in the audience. And wasn't it great seeing a legendary band leader like Sammy Kaye again? I always loved that song, too, although the word daddy was used in a slightly different context in the song than it was in our household. I was a sugar daddy, all right, but to my wife and two kids. My wife Marilyn and I can hardly believe that the two little tykes who used to make appearances on the Lawrence Welk Christmas show singing with their daddy are now beautiful young adults. Our 25-year-old son, Kevin, graduated from the University of California at Santa Cruz and is a stockbroker for an up-and-coming company called E-Trade out in the Silicon Valley. He's already had two promotions, and I'm about to let him take over my portfolio. And our daughter, Kimberly, who has a degree in hotel and restaurant management, is currently a manager at Callender's in Los Angeles, the flagship restaurant of the Marie Callender's chain. She has a little boy, Morgan James, who is going on 3 years old, and he continues to charm everyone, especially his papa and menu. That's me and his grandma, he calls menu. And he is, of course, the cutest, smartest, lovingest little guy in the world. It's great having grandchildren. And keeping with the theme of the show, I look forward to having a huge number of them.
Friends, since the show is all about numbers, and I'm in my 76th year, this next song is quite appropriate. 76 Trombones, by our good friend, the music man himself, Meredith Wilson. Gentlemen, are you ready? One, two, three.
Here's an English folk song that goes back to the Middle Ages. Paul Francis Webster wrote new words for it and called it the Twelfth of Never. Let's hear it by Guy and Ralna.
Thank you, Byron.
You ask how much I need you. Must I explain?
The bluebells forget to bloom. I'll love you till the clover has lost its perfume. I'll love you till the
Wasn't that nice? Thank you so much, Guy and Ralna. Tennessee Ernie Ford made the number 16 very popular with his big hit recording of this next song. Let's listen to Larry Hoover and the board of directors.
Here he comes now.
Gentlemen, I'm here to represent the union.
Some people say a man is made out of mud. Poor man is made out of muscle and blood. Muscle and blood and the skin and bones. A mind that's weak and a back that's strong.
You load 16 tons, what do you get?
Ba-bum-bum.
Another day older and deeper in debt.
Ba-bum-bum.
St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go.
I owe my soul to the company store.
Yes, I owe my soul to the company store.
I was born one morning when the sun didn't shine. Picked up my shovel and I walked to the mine. I loaded 16 tons of number 9 coal. The straw boss said, well, bless my soul.
You load 16 tons. What do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go.
I owe my soul to the company store.
Yes, I owe my soul to the company store.
If you see me coming, better step aside. A lot of the men didn't, and a lot of the men died. One fist of iron and the other of steel. If the right one don't get you, then the left one will.
You load 16 tons, what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go.
I owe my soul to the company store.
Hey, look at that. Okay.
You got the
Being on the Welk Show gave me the opportunity to play lots of roles, like that corporate executive with a briefcase full of money and Larry's number. But one of my real-life roles is a writer, and it's more fun than you can imagine. This is my first book, The Frozen Horror, a chilling story about the freezing and storing of human beings after death and what happens when the frozen dead are unleashed on the city of Los Angeles. That's the dark side of me. And this is my latest book, something a little bit lighter. It's a children's book titled The Ugly Little Christmas Tree, which I wrote when my daughter Kimberly was about 3 years old. A friend of mine, Sandra Keller, illustrated it, and we're presenting it to publishers right now. It's a story of a little pine tree, scrawny and misshapen, who realizes his dream through persistence and faith. And here's how the story ends. I'll just read a little bit of it here for you. And what a Christmas tree he was, sparkling from top to bottom with garlands of tinsel, baubles, and balls of every color, and twinkling lights. He was a sight to behold. Never in his wildest dreams did the little tree ever imagine a moment like this. He knew now that what he had always thought was true, that no matter how small or how ugly or how insignificant someone might be, there was some place that he would fit in perfectly, if only given the chance.
Back to our numbers show with Arthur Duncan.
Thank you. With the help of Bob Smale, Paul Humphrey, Richard Maloof, and Neil Novang, I'd like to dance down a much-traveled freeway, Route 66.
Thank you.
Arthur Duncan getting a few kicks on Route 66. Folks, you all know that Kathie Sullivan has a lovely voice, and as a rule, she sings pretty ballads. But I think you'll find she also does an excellent job with a novelty song. Let's watch and listen.
Father has a business, strictly secondhand. Everything from toothpicks to a baby grand. Stuff in our apartment came from Father's store. Even clothes I'm wearing, someone wore before. It's no wonder that I feel abused. I've never had a thing that ain't been used. I'm wearing second-hand hats, second-hand clothes. That's why they call me Second-Hand Rose. Even our piano in the parlor, Daddy bought for 10 cents on the dollar. Second-hand pearls, second-hand curls. I never get a thing that ain't been used. Even Jake the plumber, he's a man I adore. He had the nerve to tell me he's been married before. Everyone knows I'm a second-hand rose from Second Avenue. From Second Avenue.
Kate's conducting. Thank you.
More beautiful music, and this time with a beautiful lady. Ladies and gentlemen, our little Mexican señorita, Ana Cani, with a Spanish song that fits our show. Por favor.
Thank you, Myron. My song is titled Without You in English, but I thought you'd like to know the title in Spanish is Tres Palabras, meaning three words. Hope you like it.
Oye la confesión de mi secreto nace de un corazón. Con tres palabras te diré todas mis cosas, cosas del corazón que son preciosas. Dame tus manos, ven. Toma las mías que te voy a confiar. Palabras son como me gustas, son tres palabras solamente, mis angustias, y esas palabras son como
the last spot I told you about my children's book, and you probably know that Lawrence and Bernice McGeehan also wrote one. But did you know that he produced some toys for kids? And here's just one of them. It's really unique. It's called Lawrence Welk's Music Maker, and it's a pipe that came with a special mechanism to hold perforated discs, and when you blew into it and turned the handle, it played real tunes. The first CDs made in the mid-50s. Lawrence was really ahead of the times. Pretty neat, isn't it? Things like this are being sold in antique shops and are advertised in collectors' newspapers and magazines all over the country. And Welk memorabilia is even being traded and sold on the internet, and fans are having a lot of fun comparing notes on what they find. You may have a treasure in your attic or basement, and the Welk organization would love to hear about it, so give them a call.
We can always count on Mary Lou Metzger and Jack Immel to come up with something original and something appropriate. And this number show is no exception. Here they are, Two Lost Souls.
Two lost souls on the highway of life. We ain't even got a sister or brother.
But ain't it just great?
And ain't it just grand?
We got each other.
Two lost ships on a stormy sea.
One with no sail and one with no rudder.
But ain't it just great?
And ain't it just grand?
We got each other.
There is no one with whom I would rather.
Say, ain't it just great?
And ain't it just grand?
We got each other. We got each other. Got
on the highway of love.
And there is no one with whom I would rather
say, ain't it just great?
And ain't it just grand?
We got each other.
We got a lot because we got each other.
Friends, our brand new religious album, Hallelujah, has just been released. It's a collection of your all-time favorite hymns, and I believe it's one of the finest albums we have ever recorded. Bob Ballard and George Cage deserve great credit for their wonderful work on this fine album. Bob conducts our choir in one of these great songs with Joe Feeney in the solo spot. Bob, let's hear it.
Christ shall come with shout of acclamation and take me home. What joy shall fill my heart? Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou.
One of the numbers that some people think of first is their age and the number of years that go by so quickly. Just remember to use those numbers, those years, to their fullest and never fear growing old. There are many who never have the privilege. Isn't that a wonderful way to look at aging? Never fear growing old. There are many who never have the privilege. Keep smiling and we'll see you next week right here on Public Television.